Hello and welcome to News Laundry Interviews. Today we have Mr. S. Srivastava with us, who is Commissioner IT Appeal Noida. Mr. Srivastava has been in news over his allegations against NDTV and over two cases that he's currently fighting with two ladies in the Income Tax Department, Shumana Sen and Ashima Neb. Shumana Sen is the wife of an NDTV, a journalist who was formerly working with NDTV, Abhisar Sharma. News Laundry had published an article from Abhisar last week where he has made certain allegations against Mr. Srivastava. So this interview is mostly about to also allow you your side of the story. Now, Abhisar said that in a high court order, there were series of Shumana and her colleague had filed an FIR where they had said that for sexual harassment, for outraging a woman's modesty. This reached the High Court. It's currently sub judice. It matters under appeal. But the High Court had taken serious objections to certain official letters that you had sent to the chairman, CBDD of the Income Tax Department 2011. I'll just quote from some of the letters. And you have said that in one of the letters, you have said both these women, that is Mr. X, Miss X and Miss Y, apart from being in extramarital sexual intimacy with Sri P, I won't name him, and a large number of other male colleagues are also involved in organized prostitution and are prostitutes in terms of clause F. You've also said that Miss Y, garishly painted and gaudily attired befitting a prostitute of her caliber, is visiting various places including premises of principal bench, blah, blah, blah. Again, there are again allegations about by offering her body to ingratiate the debauched male lust, freely having illicit extramarital sex with her. So basically, you've said that these two women are sex workers. I want to get to that first. What is the proof? How have you come to this conclusion?
An appeal has been filed by me against the order of the Honorable Delhi High Court,
yes,
before Honorable Supreme Court, which is pending, number one. Since matter is pending, it is not correct for me to say anything about the merits of the case, number one.
Hmm.
Number two, whatever right or wrong, hmm, the Honorable Supreme Court has given repeated opportunity,
hmm,
to Abhisar Sharma's side, hmm, I mean these two ladies, women, hmm, to file their counter reply.
Hmm.
They have chosen not to file the counter reply.
It's an appeal now. 11th October is when this case will be, the next hearing will be. So it's an ongoing
so
matter.
So it is matter is sub judice.
Yeah.
Please don't ask me anything about it when the matter is before the court.
That
it's
I
a
get.
Supreme Court.
It's
please have some respect,
yes,
for the Supreme
but
Court.
But from the High Court order,
that
order there are
is,
your
that
letters.
Order
so
is
I want
that
to get to.
I can't say anything about the merit otherwise or anything of a High Court order which is subject matter of appeal before Honorable Supreme Court.
I get it. But see, a lot of portals like Manushi have written that you're being targeted.
They have not quoted from the High Court order.
No, but High Court, it's in the public domain.
Oh,
you can quote from the High Court.
But that order is under consideration of Honorable Supreme Court, Ms. Pandey.
There is one very glaring allegation against you. So
there were so many glaring allegations against me. These women went to CVC and said that I raped them.
No, they haven't. In any of the FIRs, they have not charged you
they
with
have
rape.
They have charged you with outraging a woman's modesty. No, they are lying. That was the Delhi police. They did not go and said, that's why please listen to me, Ms. Pandey.
Okay, but
respect.
Let's come to this.
I'm coming to this.
Why do you think that these two women were... Because it's a very big thing. If they were doing it,
Ms. Pandey, please tell me one interesting thing.
Anyway. We are diverging.
So,
let's come to this because these are serious charges that you have made about two women.
Now these women
obviously have the right. If someone tomorrow calls me a prostitute,
so have also been,
I will
being
get
a male. Being a male, I do not become. I do
but
not become.
There must be some
a pariah.
Yeah, of
that
course.
Is the whole
no,
problem
no, no,
with
no,
the NDTV controversy. That these two women have every right. I have no right.
But
they went to CBC.
Because the courts have also ruled in their favor, saying you must not
write
these
letters. Courts
have ruled
in my favor also. There are so many orders which they are concealing. I am giving you the order.
Hmm.
The court
but,
has...
Okay, let's come to your charges of these women indulging in activities they shouldn't be. How did you unearth this?
Yes. See, 2nd June 2006, the dates are important.
Hmm. Okay.
I have written nothing. I have done nothing. I was just doing my official duty,
okay,
sitting in my office.
Hmm.
they go to CVC and make all types of allegations against me.
Hmm.
They say, ask them what business they had in CVC. Can you go to the CVC in a procession?
Hmm.
CVC is a restricted area.
Hmm. They are both working in the vigilance department.
Also. But yeah. That also so doesn't entitle them to walk in the CVC.
Hmm. Hmm. Hmm.
We all are working for the President of India.
Hmm.
They were not something more equal than others. Hmm. They think that they were working in the
vigilance
department.
But they went and complained.
They went and indulged in illegal trade union activity, which is offense under Rule 7
How?
Of the CCS.
In the sense?
In the sense, class 1 officers are not permitted to do anything jointly. That is the rule.
Hmm.
Suppose I have a grievance, my colleague has a grievance.
Hmm.
We cannot sign a joint petition together for our grievance, even if grievances are bona fide.
No, but here it's a case of sexual harassment where they have said that we are being harassed by you.
No,
grounds of harassment seem
no,
very
No, that evident. Is all thing are later. You are not letting me then speak. Hmm. I am saying on 2nd June 2006, let them show one letter prior to 20th July 2006.
Hmm.
I have written no letter till 20th July 2006.
Hmm.
The first letter I wrote to them directly, I am giving you the copy.
Okay.
On 20th July 2006.
Hmm.
If you can find the word sexual in it, I will agree with everything.
Hmm.
Please read. I was so embarrassed myself that I am writing to a young woman.
Hmm.
I used the word gender sensitive and gender specific.
Hmm.
When I learned that they have gone to CVC and accused me of raping them.
No, but they have not accused you of raping
them. They have.
Nowhere have they.
Let us examine then the officers of the CVC.
I am examining public records. They have not.
They are lying. They are lying. You have not seen the
so
CVC
we,
records.
Let's not say who's lying, who's not, because we can't get into that. But let's get into the facts that
we have. I am saying just a minute.
Hmm.
Why? What reply they gave to this letter?
What?
It's an official letter.
Hmm, hmm, hmm.
I wrote an official DO letter to them. Asking them to act with clean hands.
Hmm.
I did not use the word sexual. I said gender. You are making gender specific allegations.
But after that
me.
You wrote lots of letters to
when?
Various people saying like one was on 2011.
You are, why are you jumping to 11 when we are in 2006, Ms. Pandey?
Because
please.
The case was filed in 2009. Now,
no,
2006,
no.
Before
case
that, what happened?
Case
I don't
started
know.
In 2005. Then please find out. You
no,
are a
that
journalist.
Is NDTV.
You
now,
cannot, Ms. Pandey, you cannot allow yourself to be manipulated by Mr. Vishal Sharma.
Why will he manipulate?
Then don't allow.
But no,
he
but
will manipulate
is, no,
because
this is
he
a
is
public
guilty.
Record. See, there are two important things in this cases. One is sexual harassment case against you. One is NDTV's irregularities. Let's get to the first one properly. Let's establish what made you believe that these two women were indulging in prostitution.
Why you are segregating a minor issue? You want to take up the
but
minor issue?
But it's not
issue?
Minor because there are cases
though
on this filed against you which is discrediting your other
No,
case
no,
NDTV.
Nothing has been discredited. The
but
Vishakha
because
committee,
there are such big
please,
allegations
please,
against you.
Please, Vishakha committee has inquired into everything and found their allegations
the Supreme
to be
Court
bogus.
Has said that those allegations have to be re-looked into and
no,
by
Supreme
December
Court has not
31st,
said. No, no, no,
an
please,
inquiry
no,
has to be
no,
done by December
no,
31st
no,
for
no,
which...
No, no, they are again manipulating the
this
media.
This is the Supreme Court saying
please read
that
the Supreme
by
Court
December
order.
31st,
please read
please
the Supreme
submit,
Court order.
Give us an inquiry into
Ms.
all allegations against you.
Ms. Pandey, please read the Supreme Court. Supreme Court has said only one thing. Honorable Supreme Court in their judgment of 18th September 2009 has said that an inquiry by somebody senior to me so that he is not influenced by me.
So that,
please,
yeah.
please, please.
Hmm, hmm.
An inquiry, again I am saying, don't saying what Supreme Court has said. The Honorable Supreme Court in their judgment dated 18th September 2015, they said two things.
Hmm.
One, three departmental inquiries against me which were pending and which these two women were complaining and which they wanted to be completed should be completed within 6 months and I was asked
yeah,
to cooperate.
By March.
I am cooperating.
Okay.
Second, they said that the allegation of these two women that their grievances was not looked into by the government should be inquired by somebody whether any action is required to be taken
not.
Against anyone, not against me.
Against
anyone, meaning thereby against these two women also.
It's basically looking to their allegations.
No, it is basically looking into the facts that whether an action was required, an action was taken.
A fact-finding.
Fact-finding
yeah.
inquiry
yeah.
in the
yeah.
controversy, not against person A or person B. It is not an inquiry against me or against them.
Hmm.
It is an inquiry of the facts.
Looking into what exactly
so
happened,
tomorrow,
charges against
the inquiry, on the based on inquiry, action can be taken against them also, against me also, against anybody else also.
But these letters calling somebody a prostitute is not
what I have done, what I have not done is will be looked into by the concerned inquiries.
But there must be something that you would have thought for
that will be produced in the inquiry. That has been produced in the inquiry.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you ask Mr. Abhishad Sharma to tell the media about the TA bill submitted by Ms. Sumana Sen in December 2005? Ms. Sumana Sen traveled to Bangalore in November 2005.
Okay.
The TA bill is to be submitted within 1 month of the completion of journey. And then in December 2005, she submitted a TA bill. What did she disclose there? I don't want to. I will not say that what did she disclose. Let Mr. Vishal Sharma, all your answers will be given to you. You will get all your answers. Your journalistic inquisitiveness will be satisfied.
Which is what I want to know, that how does a TA bill establish prostitution? Like, what is in that TA bill?
First read the TA bill. But anything will establish anything. Miss Pandey.
That's what I'm saying. Anything can establish anything. But
anything can
but
establish.
What is it in
so
that TA
I
bill?
Want Mr. Abhishad Sharma to inform the public, the listeners, I mean readers of your
portal. But a TA bill is basically where you stay, what you eat.
But if you disclose something else, nobody can prevent you, na? If you can write, it is being filled up by you. Sometimes you end up disclosing by not disclosing anything.
But what? I mean, I
let
don't
the
get
TA
it.
Bill. I asked for a copy of the TA bill. I was not given. Okay. I asked under RTI. I was not given.
So you have not seen the TA bill.
I am aware of it. Seen
how?
Is one thing. How?
Someone else told you something about the TA bill.
I trust myself.
You have not seen the TA bill yourself.
I can't deny it, I can't admit it, but I am confident of my sources. My sources have told what is there, and that is sufficient defense for me.
But
for whatever
what is it
they
in
are
a TA
telling.
Bill? I will say, okay, I stayed here, ate a samosa, I had
and
lunch,
suppose you write something which has some larger meaning, legal like meaning.
What?
See, legal meaning, there's a difference.
But what can you write in a TA bill that makes you a prostitute?
You can write anything. It is up to you.
But
what she has, forget what you can write. You see.
No, I'm curious to know that.
Yeah, I appreciate your curiosity. Should be there. Any intelligent person should become curious after what I'm saying. Something is written there. Mr. Gurumurthy in his letter and Mr. Ram Jethmalani in his letter has referred to that. It is not that it is not in public domain.
But what? If it's in the public domain, then you can say it. I mean, you've seen the TA bill, so you can, and you've based.
I have not seen. I'm saying I know.
You are aware of it.
I'm aware, and I trust my sources.
But what was it in that TA bill that you saw and said, okay, these women are prostitutes? What was it?
I'm saying one thing. Whatever I have written, if I have written, I will take the responsibility. I have taken the responsibility. I have never run away from the responsibility. I have fought my battle with clean hands and with my head high. It is they who have been acting in the shadows.
But that's what I'm saying. How, like, if you're making such a claim, how? Like, how are you saying they're acting in shadows? Or how is it that...
Yeah, I'm telling you. Please. They're
because
acting.
That's why
Ms. Pandey...
It's a very big correlation from a TA bill.
It's a very big controversy. The stakes, please see the stakes. NDTV in March 2004 did not have money to pay salary.
We'll come to NDTV.
No, I'm not doing NDTV. I'm telling the stakes. These women have been used by NDTV to scuttle the inquiry undertaken by me. These women have been used by Mr. Chidambaram to bury the inquiry.
But that's a very long distance correlation you're making. These women have been used by Mr. Chidambaram to scuttle your looking into. How?
I am saying, how? Yes, that's very
how
good.
How are these women being used?
Yes, these
okay,
women.
Okay, first we'll come to.
I'm coming. These women, you asked me a very good question, how? These women have been used because Mr. Chidambaram, after wasting lots and lots of public resources, he set up almost every government agency on me. He could not find anything or he did not find anything. So, it's very easy in our society to set up a man by setting up women against him.
Okay.
So that is what they did. NDTV and Chidambaram did. And there is a direct nexus.
Now,
I'm telling you.
You are saying that these two women were used.
I am telling you one thing, Ms. Pandey, with due respect. Allow me. I am at the receiving end. You are a neutral arbiter. Let Ms. Ashima Neb tell the public who paid her bills in Anahita Resort in Mauritius and why. Simple thing.
It could be anyone, but that doesn't establish prostitution.
Come clean. Come clean.
But I can go on a trip and my father can pay your on father, my thing, so or you're, my boyfriend
Pandey,
or my,
Ms. Pandey,
my friend.
Ms.
That
Pandey.
Doesn't establish me as a prostitute.
No. I'm not using the word also, what you were using.
But that's what your letter
saying. Just a minute. I am saying only one thing, Ms. Pandey, with due respect, with folded hand. As you said, your father, your brother, or you yourself. You
or
are
my
a working woman.
Or someone,
anybody,
my fiance.
Anybody. If the sources are legitimate, you should disclose it, at least before the authorities.
But it's a personal vacation.
No, income tax, there's nothing personal in income tax law.
I mean, you can't ask me tomorrow who's paying for my hotel. If it's my friend, suppose
no,
it's
no,
a
no,
gift
no, no,
given
no.
to
just
me.
Just a minute. Assessing officer will ask that Miss Pandey or anybody, matlab names are immaterial. I'm sorry for using your surname.
Okay.
Miss A, B, C, D. Please tell who paid your expenses on your honeymoon trip. You will have to tell. The person will have.
The part about where these two ladies have been accused of prostitution by you, the High Court said that please don't write such letters.
As I said, with due respect
then,
again.
Then
I, as
you
I
wrote
said,
another letter.
I what? See, please.
Then the High Court issued contempt.
No, you are, please, you are, now we are committing contempt of the High Court. Please, I request you, please, I have some knowledge of law.
But if the High Court is saying don't write such letters,
please,
then
that
they
matter
also
is before, that matter
they
is
recognize
before,
that these are baseless allegations.
That matter is before Honorable Supreme Court. Things are to be read in context. I can tell you Supreme Court judgments where they have said the text is to be read in the context.
No, the context is in the...
So context is that will be decided in the Supreme Court. Please bear with me. You can have an interview after Supreme Court judgment.
Yeah, sure, we can do that. But.
I'll tell you why this is important. I cannot speak anything about High Court judgment because that matter is before Honorable Supreme Court. Please spare me. I have, at least I am aware of the position, legal position. I have to remain quiet till the matter is decided by their lordship of the Supreme Court. Whatever they will decide is bound, is binding on me. I am bound by that. I will obey. High Court has passed an order, I am not denying. I have gone to Honorable Supreme Court. Their lordships were pleased to examine the case on merits. Matter is pending. Let the Honorable Supreme Court decide.
Okay, so just to finish this matter here, you are saying this is being discussed at the court now. You will not want to comment on it. Your reasons for saying that these two women were involved in sex work is because of their TA.
No, I'm not saying this. I'm not saying this also.
But that's what you said.
I said you please, first you read the TA bill. You will not ask me any question afterwards. Please, you are a young woman, Ms. Pandey. Don't embarrass me. I am making a humble request. Please ask Mr. Abhishar Sharma to make two things clear. Mr. I can give you one letter I wrote to Mr. Chidambaram.
No, I mean, but just on this, this aspect of the case,
see,
of sexual harassment.
Again, I request News Laundry not to confine itself to what Mr. Abhishar Sharma wants.
No, Abhishar is not saying. This is in the public domain.
See,
this
there
is
should
a,
be extra.
This is a case you're involved in right now.
Ms. Pandey.
As a senior official, it's a very big case.
Yes, I'm saying it's a very big
to
case.
To be involved in.
Yes.
Because very serious allegations.
So, all those allegations have been looked into by the Vishakha committee.
Again, it's being relooked by the Supreme Court.
No, it is not being relooked. That is the misinterpretation Mr. Abhishar Sharma is doing. The only thing being looked
Let's
into.
Let's not bring Abhishar in it. This is matter in the court now. It's public document.
No, that judgment is already passed. That inquiry, fact-finding inquiry is going on.
Which will look into all these allegations.
Which will look into. So, no, not the allegations. Please. The fact
it will look
finding,
at both sides
no,
of the allegations.
No, Ms. Pandey,
why,
please.
Why? It will of course look at the charges
against
you.
No, Ms. Pandey, that is not the directions of the Honorable Supreme Court. The Honorable Supreme Court has said only one thing, qua these two women, that whether their grievances, that their allegations, their complaints were not looked into is correct or not. Meaning thereby, suppose they said that please file an FIR, an FIR was not filed. So only then that FIR was not filed, then Supreme Court in their wisdom, they will do whatever they feel appropriate. So they are again misinterpreting the Supreme Court judgment the way they have been doing all along before various courts.
So,
like I'm telling you one thing, Abhishar, because that is in the article itself, so you have to cover. Mr. Abhishar Sharma has referred to an order by 2G Scam Court dated 3rd December 2012. Okay.
Yeah.
And he said that he was given a clean chit. Mr. Vishal Sharma should be told that clean chits are given only to the accused, those who face trial.
Hmm.
When did he face the trial that he got a clean chit?
Yeah.
Forget that. Hmm. Mr. Vishal Sharma is concealing this order 14th December 2011.
Hmm. A Raja versus other.
Yeah. Yes, yeah. Same court. The court said we have not passed any order on merit, meaning thereby nobody has been given any clean chit. The unfortunate part is that because of the position enjoyed by Mr. Chidambaram or NDTV or Mr. Vishal Sharma, nobody is asking this basic question. Mr. Ram Jethmalani in his letter dated 29 December 2013 blasted Chidambaram on this. And Chidambaram did not dare reply. Nobody has been given any clean chit. Yes, my application for examination as a prosecution witness was not accepted
by the
Honorable Court. I accepted the judgment of the Honorable Court. Court imposed, please, this is very important.
Hmm.
And it is in the context of this article.
Hmm.
Court imposed a cost of ₹10,000 on me. I paid it.
Okay.
For cost is imposed for unnecessarily using the judicial time.
Yeah.
Because judicial time is precious, that time can be used for some needy person. Mm. There is a difference between cost and fine. Cost is compensatory, fine is punitive. Mr. Vishal Sharma has used the word fine. He is not a layman, he is not an auto rickshaw driver that he will not understand.
This has been awarded because they feel that you have wasted the time of the judicial.
Cost, not the fine.
But it will not be a cost. Suppose there are my allegations are correct, or the court sees merit in it to initiate action, I don't have to bear the cost.
So just
I will only bear the cost.
So I said cost. Cost is compensatory. Hmm. Assuming, hmm. suppose I agreed to meet you at 3, and you left your other work.
But they didn't see merit in it.
So no. Merit is different thing. Hmm. No, merit is that they have clarified.
See, judicial they have
order,
said that.
See, afterward,
has leveled unsubstantiated and unwarranted
Ms.
allegations.
Ms. Pandey, the judicial discipline says that last order is the final order.
Hmm.
So an order was passed by Honorable Court. There was some background why that order got passed. Mr. Sharma is again misrepresenting.
No, please.
Those who practice law will appreciate that.
Hmm.
Now, when we pointed out to the court that inherent misuse, the possibility of inherent misuse in the hands of interested parties, court appreciated our concern.
Hmm.
Court passed another order.
Hmm.
And that order is this.
Hmm.
Nothing more is required to be added or modified as prayed in the application.
Hmm. So this is in respect to the first one, so they are not...
No, so that's why I am saying now this is the final order.
Hmm.
This order operates now, not that order. In judicial discipline, suppose 10 orders are passed by me, my last order is the final order. Because I have the benefit of reading my earlier orders. My mind
but
knows...
But they have not initiated an inquiry against Abhishar and his wife.
Who?
The courts. They have not found merit in the allegations that you went to, the CBI court.
I didn't go for inquiry against anyone. I said, please, that's why I'm saying the final distinction of law.
Hmm.
I mean, check with a lawyer if you don't believe me.
Hmm.
Just verify with a lawyer what I'm saying. I went for one small prayer under section 311 of the CRPC that you examine me as a witness of the government in this controversy.
Hmm.
I said, I will tell you what has happened.
Hmm.
Court said, no, thank you.
Hmm.
And then court said that you have wasted my time.
Hmm.
This time could have been used in a much better way.
Hmm.
So you compensate. I said, fine.
Hmm.
I agree.
Hmm.
I paid it. Nobody penalized me.
Yeah, sure. Okay.
Please, legally. I mean, don't let us go by the layman's
it's
understanding.
Sure.
In the legal language, I was not penalized. So when Mr. Abhishar Sharma, who is a journalist and who has an opinion on almost everything under the sun, who enjoys passing judgment about anyone and everyone, he should not use a word which is legally incorrect.
Well, yeah, I mean, I think the point here being that it is a layman word to use, but the point here being
he's
that you will only
layman.
Be charged with a cost if they feel...
To compensate.
When they feel that what you came with was unwarranted and unsubstantiated and wasted the cost.
No. Compensate the time. As I told you, I agreed to meet you at 3.
Also, it's a measure to make sure that it doesn't happen again, that people don't keep coming to the courts with, you know, unsubstantiated...
You are slightly enlarging the scope of
it
compensation.
It acts as a deterrent.
It makes you feel
that if you waste the
court time, you
will be...
It is not that large. It simply says, limited, that you have wasted my time.
Okay, so the sexual harassment cases aside, it's in the court. You say you have reasons to believe all these things.
I am saying that whatever I have written, if I have written, I have sufficient evidence to prove to that prove? In a court of law. Mr. Abhisar Sharma and Ms. Ashima Neb, Ms. Ramona Sen can test their case or my case before a defamation court.
Okay.
Let a defamation.
So that's currently pending. There's an appeal.
And since Mr. Vishal Sharma has signed off his article by saying that courts will decide, let us have some faith in the courts.
But anyway, let's leave that aside. My point to bring that up was only to ascertain that there's a case against you. You stand by the letter. You stand
what?
By
no,
what?
I'm not standing by anything. Please, I don't know which letter, what letter. Please.
The ones that are quoted in the High Court. Order.
High Court order is subject matter of the consideration of Honorable Supreme Court. So, I am waiting for that. Whatever Supreme Court will decide, I have to obey.
Okay. So now let's come to NDTV.
Other than High Court order, other than High Court order, there are other matters in the article of Mr. Sharma, which I am repeatedly pointing out that Mr. Sharma has not given any clean chit by the CBI court. Nobody has been given, in fact.
Let's stick to Ashima and... Shumona and Abhishar, let's come to their central conflict of interest that you have brought about. You have said that in 2005, Shumona as assistant commissioner got NDTV a refund of 1.47 crore. You are saying it's under her watch that this has happened. She has directed it. She has said that I have not directed anything. I have only signed it under section 143.1. I am not allowed to assess it.
Can I interrupt in you here for a moment?
Yeah. I just want to present both sides. And you have said that in lieu of this, she has gotten this done. They got.
I have not said this. That is what they are. They want to make it. They want to confine the case of a clear case of corruption and bribery to one single incident.
So what are you saying?
I am saying that Ms. Sumana Sen and Ms. Ashima Neb were set up by NDTV to fake sexual harassment against me so that I am placed under illegal suspension by Mr. Chidambaram. I fought my illegal suspension, got it quashed by the court. Sumana Sen and Ashima Neb, complicity. They went and filed a writ petition in Delhi High Court saying that I should maybe kept under suspension. Who the hell are they? The suspension of an employee is between employer and employee.
But if you write letters calling
No, they didn't go for that. They simply straight away filed this writ petition. Please don't bring the letters. Then entire letter should be here.
But Ms. because Pandey, their case Ms. is Pandey, based on the letter.
Then entire case. No, it is not based on letter. They are lying. They are because
but
they have been
caught. But it's in the public domain.
See, everything is in public
they
domain.
They have only accused you of
outraging a woman's modesty. No. They went to CVC. As I said, I have not written any letter. The letter you are quoting, you are yourself saying 2011.
One of the letters is 2011 so, Pandey, from the High Court judgment.
Ms. Pandey, why did they go to CVC in June 2006? Why? Which letter they are talking about in June 2006?
There were previously letters you've written. I am only putting one letter
from
2011.
I have not written any letter. Let them show one single letter prior to 20th July 2007. They have 2006. They are Mr. Vishal Sharma is manipulating the media, unfortunately, and media is getting itself into it. Please, no letter was written prior to 20th July 2006. This is the first letter I have written, and I have written right to them. And I gave a copy to my female superior, my female superior, let us not take the name.
Okay. So, there are lots of letters in this.
They are only planting because Mr. Vishal Sharma is from media.
He can't plant stories. I mean, this he can't plant.
Not your letter. I mean, your article.
Yeah.
He is because, it is peerless. It is called peer.
No, but if there is no merit in... There is a certain record that High Court keeps. High Court says that these letters are happening.
See, Ms. Pandey, you are only... Why only one order they are talking about? There are 10...
Because sexual harassment is that
There are n number of... There is one order by the High Court.
Okay.
What Sumana Sen did...
Okay, we are just going round and round.
No, we are not going round. Please listen. You are not listening. Ms. Sumana Sen went and told Delhi High Court that she belongs to 1987 batch of IRS. It is my batch, not her batch. She is 12 years junior.
This I can't verify because I have to...
I will give you the order. I will give you the order of the Delhi High Court. I will give her petition. It is not a question of verifying. It is not that simply a question of verification. It's a judicial order. See there what they have been doing and what they are up to. A petitioner is an officer of Indian Revenue Service of 1987 batch. Petitioner is Sumana Sen. See her fraud. Ask what is going on in her mind.
Okay, I will.
She claims that she is an officer of 1987 okay, batch of IRS.
Then Delhi
High Court has to pass another order saying that no, she is not from 87 batch of IRS, she is from 99 batch of IRS.
Okay, so let's
something
get back
is very seriously wrong with the mind of Ms. Sumana Sen.
Okay, so now let's get back to Sumana Sen.
Ji.
Ka jo, you are saying ki refund 1.47 crore ka diya NDTV. In return, they have got foreign trips.
No, not in return. No. It is a larger
package. So, what have they got in return for giving this?
So many things they got. So
like
many
what?
Things they got.
Like what?
So many things. I do not know.
But,
Mr. Vishad Sharma
if you
purchased.
Don't know, then how
Mr. Vishad Sharma purchased.
But you are making this. You have said that they have got things.
Did you allow me to complete the inquiry?
No, but your but you, there you, must be a basis of the inquiry. No?
There is a basis of inquiry.
So
there
you are alleging wrongdoing, corruption.
Yes,
and
I am alleging
quid pro quo and
yes,
conflict
yes,
of interest.
Yes, I am
for this 1.47 crore, what did Sumana
that is one particular instance of corruption. There are so many others.
But what did they get for it is what I want to know. Like,
see,
because it's a
I'm
serious
saying, nah,
charge again.
You do not allow the evidence gathering investigation. Hmm. See what happened.
So you are saying that it.
What was the hurry to place me under suspension? What heaven was falling on 30th March 2007 to place me under suspension? To serve the order of suspension on me in the night. Mr. Chidambaram was having attacks.
Okay.
I
so
was
but
prevented
let's,
to
let's
prevented
not talk
to
about Chidambaram because in this case what
it
is
it has
important?
To be because Mr. Chidambaram is the main kingpin.
Okay.
He has taken bribe. It is the bribe money of Chidambaram which NDTV was laundering and which I took up for inquiry, and that's why in panic they set up these women to fake sexual harassment, and using that, Mr. Chidambaram suspended me.
Okay, we can't say fake sexual harassment because they have presented
it is
proof.
Fake. No, they didn't say.
But
no,
they have given
no,
out
it is
letters.
Fake. Ms. Pandey, it is a faking of sexual harassment. Please.
Are you saying you didn't write those letters?
That is a separate thing.
But that is the basis
letters
of
not,
them saying sexual harassment.
That is a separate thing. Please don't
it's
mix up.
It's not separate. It is the case.
Please, no, it is not the case. They said that they were raped by me in CVC. We
no,
will examine Ranjana
no,
Kumar.
They have said that you have outraged their modesty. Nowhere
they are lying.
Have they said,
it was Delhi police. Delhi police said that we cannot register an FIR beyond 509.
No, but
APC.
That I won't take because then FIR,
see,
they will register a rape FIR.
No,
or a
no. There are so many consequences.
Okay, coming back to NDTV, we're just going round and round.
No,
we have to do this quickly.
Pandey,
no. See, it will
Ms.
get
Pandey.
Edited out, so there's no point. We'll keep fighting. Wo edit karna padega. So let's just
Ms.
Pandey, let's come to. 1.47 crore.
The CVC asked them to lodge FIR in June 2006 and they lodged FIR in September 2009. Why
okay,
this delay of 27
let's
months?
I just think that because sexual harassment is a serious case, we should not, you know. And
faking of sexual
not,
harassment is equally serious
it's
case.
It's very serious.
Please don't. Please don't that males have no right in this country.
No, males have every
I am
right.
a male, so I have become a criminal and they are a female.
No,
they have
no,
license
no.
for everything.
I don't think
they
you're a criminal.
No, that is what they are making it. They will fake sexual harassment. Why did they go to CVC?
No, but because they have letters yes. written by you by your colleagues.
I did not write any letter on 2006. In 2006, Ms. Pandey, they went to CVC because they
but
were paid
said,
money.
You have been saying things about them. You verbally said things to
I
them.
I didn't say. No, they are lying. I didn't say anything verbally. They are lying.
But you would
they,
say a lot of...
No, I didn't say anything.
Okay.
I do not speak orally.
So, okay, that's,
I take the
that's
responsibility.
Your, that's your...
they went to CVC
That's your right to say... Now
Ms.
let's
Pandey,
come to,
they went to CVC because they were set up by their paymasters to go to CVC. Paymasters were NDTV and Mr. Chidambaram and fake sexual harassment so that Mr. Chidambaram can place me under suspension. And no, suspension was only when he failed to dismiss me under Article 311.2.
But there were also corruption allegations that were being...
No corruption allegation. Sumana Sen is a cheat. No corruption allegation is pending against me even today.
No, they were being probed.
There was never, no.
In the CVC.
No.
Where
these,
she was
no,
in the department.
No, there is not a single case of corruption of one paisa against me. Let them come out with the documents.
Okay.
The allegations against me.
But this has
me,
been reported
see,
on.
No, nothing is reported.
Cases.
These two women are lying
okay.
because they have no other defense. The long ago, George Bernard Shaw said, patriotism is the last refuge of a scoundrel. I am adding to it. Modesty is the first defense of a rascal.
Okay, now we should just quickly come to NDTV's
Please.
Case. Now, 1.47 crore refund, aapne kaha ki wo gaya. Now, iske badle ye bribe, you have said that they have taken
I have said. See,
now, I want to know what is the bribe? What did Sumana and Abhishar get for this 1.47 crore?
Yeah, I am saying let there be first impartial inquiry. Because of the predominance of Mr. Chidambaram and manipulation by Mr. Pranav Roy, Mr. Pranav Roy has a nasty habit of approaching even my lawyers. Every time an important case comes up, he lands up to the house of the lawyer of the opposite party and tries to meddle with it.
Okay, but coming back to...
So that's what I'm telling you. If you do not allow any inquiry to take place and then subject me to the strict rule of evidence, what do I do?
No, but there must be a basis for an inquiry.
There is a basis.
We have to present
some... There is a basis. I am saying a government servant, that the government rule says that if a government servant who does not give intimation of conflict of interest should be dismissed. Here is a person who concealed, who says, I told orally to this man or that man, that is between
her boss. Her boss. She told it to her boss. Things, who she is reporting to.
No, oral intimations are not given. There are no intimations.
Okay, but that is an established bribe.
Conflict that establishes, interest, yes, that first thing first. Here is a woman or officer, forget the men or women. Here is an officer who conceals her conflict of interest, number one.
Okay.
Here is an officer who says that case is taken away from her and still passes order. Here is an
signed
officer.
It according to
pass what? The order, please. I'm sorry, I'm not shouting on you.
No.
I'm shouting because I'm myself out.
Because I also want to know 143.1 says.
See, it is like this. Let me give half a minute. Income Tax Act has procedure for everything. One section says how the assessments will be done. Section 143 is the assessment section. Meaning thereby, when you a taxpayer files a return of income, the assessing officer who can be of any rank, why assistant commissioner who can be a lower rank of income tax officer also, he will see the return and if he feels that there is something which needs deeper inquiry, he will start processing under section 143. Now 143 has three subsections, 143.1, 2 and 3.
Yeah.
143.1 says that you will make a summary inquiry, meaning thereby you will just go through something which can be verified very easily without putting the taxpayer to some deeper inquiry.
Only an intimation, not a scrutiny assessment order is what it says.
See, this is the wording of Sumana Sen
and
Amitav Sharma.
This is 143.1 of income tax, I am reading from that. Intimation under 143.1,
yes. So
auto-generated letter by the computers of the income tax department.
From where you are reading? I also keep humility. Reading Income Tax Act 10 times a day.
How to deal with internal section?
From where I don't know.
143.1 of income tax.
I'm reading it from the book itself. Where a return has been made under section 139 or in response of so and so, such return shall be processed in the following manner, namely, the total income or loss shall be computed after making the following adjustments. This is 143.1. Then
intimation under 143.1 is an auto-generated letter.
Where it is auto? Miss Pandey, I can't go beyond this. This is the law. What you are reading, I don't know. Somebody might have given his personal opinion.
No, it's
Miss Pandey, this is the act. Please.
Okay.
We can't go
beyond
that.
No, but does
that.
It say that the assessment officer computes it? Is the assessment officer computing it?
It says in the beginning itself, the return shall be processed in the following manner. Process is not signing. Processing is a composite process.
But they're not saying assessment officer is processing it. Who's processing it?
Assessing officer. Please, I can't teach you the whole income tax law
okay.
in 30 seconds.
Let's leave that. Okay, fine. Maan liya ki she signed this.
She is lying.
And
she passed the order. Please, no. Okay. I'm adamant on this. She passed the order.
She passed it. Okay, let's take that. Now, what did she get in return?
Go and look into her house. There may be mink coats, fur coats.
That's where
there may be diamond jewelry.
But that's, sir, wo to fir
how can I say what did she get? She, one minute.
We are talking about bribe. We are talking about quid.
Yes,
popo.
Bribe. So NDTV bribed her. Why NDTV will send? NDTV has not sent Ravish Kumar and his family for a foreign vacation. NDTV did not
Maybe
send Mr. Dibang. No. I'm taking names after one another. Mr. Dibang has never been given this. Miss Nagma Sahar has never been given. She's from Patna, so I know her. Miss Nagma Sahar has never been given this.
Six employees in NDTV have been given.
Give me the names. We will verify up from the records.
But
till date, nobody has taken, NDTV has not given, and NDTV is giving, telling repeatedly that we do not give. I don't know from where six employees are coming. NDTV says we never gave any such perquisite to anyone. And if Mr. Vishal Sharma has that much of talent, why the other employers have not given it to him? His talent disappeared after NDTV. The only one's condition was there, which is not there anywhere else.
That we don't know whether he's getting them now.
He's not getting, I know.
How?
Because when you pay something to somebody, you deduct tax on that. So it comes in your records.
This is part of his CTC.
It is not his part of CTC. NDTV has denied.
You are saying apart from CTC, they were given foreign trips. Now,
Anything which is not part of your employment is bribe. If you are.
But he has said that it's part of my CTC.
Who said? He's an accused. He can say anything. Whether it is borne by the records of NDTV, that is more important. Third party record has to be relied upon. Mr. Vishar Sharma can tomorrow say that he is the president of the United States.
So you are saying that NDTV doesn't have a record of his travels.
No, not record. Yeah. NDTV has categorically denied that we did not give any such perquisite to any of our employees, including Abhisar Sharma. So where is the question of record? Obviously, if you have not spent money on, let us say, your brother to buy a shirt for him, from where will you produce the bill? Unless you spend the money, only then you produce the bill. So NDTV is categorically denying that we never gave any such thing to Abhisar Sharma. From where should I give the detail? I don't know from where Abhisar Sharma is talking of CTC or this or that. He can go on talking. He did not produce any such record in course of his assessment. His wife did not produce any such record in course of assessment. NDTV did not produce anything. And he is planting things and documents on the media by fabricating it.
No, he's not planting anything right now because, okay, so now let's come to the allegation against them. 1.47 crore ke liye, you are saying they got a foreign trip, one foreign trip.
That's not one. Yearly vacation abroad with family, that is what Ms. Sumana Sen and Ms. Ashima
and Nair. How much did these cost?
I can't comment because I have no access to the primary records. But it can cost anything. It can cost few lakh rupees, it can cost several crores. Depend what do you do in your foreign trips.
Suppose what is NDTV finance? The NDTV finance a trip you're saying. So how much did these trips that
I don't know. NDTV might have delivered money in bags. Money is delivered not only by.
But then there is so much conjecture.
No, there's no conjecture. No conjecture.
Because we're saying
that
maybe
is what Mr. Abhisar Sharma is trying to make it out to cover up his
crime. Asking you.
Yeah.
You,
I am saying not I am, him. So I am saying there should have been a transparent inquiry to avoid all these controversies.
Okay. You're saying ki fair inquiry honi chahiye. We don't know whether bribe liya hai, nahi liya hai.
No, I know bribe liya hai. Bribe liya hai. Quantification pe main comment nahi kar raha hu. Please, I have some 29 years behind me. Ms. Sumana Sen, I am saying it categorically. I am saying it publicly. I am saying through your portal with full responsibility. Let Mr. Abhisar Sharma contest it in a defamation court. Mr. Abhisar Sharma and Ms. Sumana Sen took bribe from NDTV. Number one.
As what? What was this bribe? I'm working for someone. I do something for them, do a favor. I say, okay, main News Laundry mein story likh dungi. And I'm taking something from them. Now, either the money will reach my account or I would spend it or there is some proof of the money reaching me through bags.
I'm saying, yes.
So, what is the trail? I want to know the money trail.
Now, you are on the quantum of the bribe.
No, and the trail also. How do we establish that this money from NDTV reached?
One specific instance is, on the one side, she does not give intimation. She issues illegally an illegal refund of 1,46,82,836 is the exact quantum. Then she lies to the government that she has never dealt with the case of NDTV.
She has not dealt with the case. She said that I signed it and I.
You do not sign. Who the hell are you? You are a film actress.
No, the scrutiny case she was not.
Why will you sign?
No, there was a scrutiny case against NDTV, right?
There is, she was not a cinema actress who was signing autographs. Okay. She was signing a statutory document.
2004, there was a scrutiny case
Ms.
against
Pandey,
NDTV.
There lies the crux. Please open your mind. I cannot sign something which I am not authorized to sign. If I sign, I am committing a crime. Ms. Sumana Sen was the assessing officer. Please, she did not sign. She passed
an
order.
She's given a refund.
Giving refund is a very serious. Yes.
But what is the illegality of giving refunds to subcom?
Refund was not due. That is the illegality.
It was because the scrutiny was going on.
No, refund was not due.
Why?
Refund was not due, so not due.
But how do we establish that it wasn't due?
Because refund is to be determined due. It was not due because of the Supreme Court judgment.
Because of the scrutiny.
No, because of the Supreme Court judgment. Supreme Court judgment. She is concealing the Supreme Court judgment of 2002. Gujarat State Electricity Board versus Commissioner of Income Tax.
Saying what?
Saying that when 143.2 is pending, 142.1 will not be passed.
That means when scrutiny is ongoing.
In layman's term, I am speaking legally.
So if there is a scrutiny happening, so scrutiny was happening. Now she said that 2013-14 में ये introduce हुआ था.
झूठ बोल रही है. Supreme Court judgment 2002 में आ गया. मैडम कितनी बार कहें आपको? थोड़ी मेरे पर मेहरबानी करिए. सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जजमेंट लॉ ऑफ द लैंड होता है, बाइंडिंग है हम सभी के लिए, आपके लिए भी, मेरे लिए भी. आप सुप्रीम कोर्ट के
खिलाफ. So you are saying that she shouldn't have passed it because scrutiny was going on.
She has no authority to pass, number one.
Okay.
Number two, no
refund.
But why
in this whole organization, how can they let one assistant officer pass things?
Because these orders are passed by assistant commissioners only, not by the chairman CBDT. Please, this is the book. It confers statute.
No, but if something like this is happening, won't her department initiate an inquiry?
Yeah, department attempted.
They said there is no case of vigilance.
Mr. Chidambaram says that nothing happened in
Chidambaram, her department.
No, Mr. Chidambaram was the finance minister. Please, the moment Chidambaram.
He's not going to look into departmental goings on of, you know, every little commissioner.
He keeps track of my slightest movement.
Okay.
By now, he must be getting answers that what Ms. Pandey is talking to me. He has some respect for his mischievous abilities.
But he is no longer in power. Now what can he do?
He is no longer in power, but he is still very powerful. He is Mr. Chidambaram.
So apart from NDTV, what other cases do you have that you are scrutinizing? Or are there any other
tax evasion
or bribe?
No, I mean, it will not be fair. Right now, of course, since Chidambaram, NDTV things have come in public. Other cases like the case... Somebody came and asked me about D&D, that Noida toll case. So I told him whatever was permissible in law. There are a lot many other appeals. I hear all the appeals, any appeal by an aggrieved income taxpayer from Noida, except one particular category, international transactions. So whosoever is aggrieved by an order passed by a junior officer of the income tax authority, you are talking of assistant commissioner, probably Somna Sen said that I was a very junior officer. Assistant commissioner is a class one post. Income tax officers are class 2 posts, they also pass these orders. So there is no junior, senior in a judicial hierarchy. You pass whatever authority is given to you.
As a government officer, you know you are bound by rules where you cannot talk to the media.
I can talk to the media to defend the government.
You can. But this is, you are defending yourself in this.
No, I am defending the government. Please read my letter. Because Mr. Vishal Sharma has cast aspersions on the government also.
How?
Yeah, in his article. He says government is not doing. He has cast aspersions on the present government.
You've said that. So you are saying that.
So I am saying.
You are saying you can talk to the media because you're defending. But you know, you also talk to Manushi, Gurumurthy. He's taken up your case really well,
and I'm grateful to him.
He's written a lot.
Is he
a friend, or have you common meeting?
I have no stature to claim friendship with Mr. Gurumurthy. I am just.
So the common link is NDTV. That's what brought you two together.
And Chidambaram.
NDTV and Chidambaram.
We share our contempt for both.
For both. And that's how you... Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
If you like that, click here to support us and down here to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and do check out the other stuff we do, like News Laundry interviews, Why So Serious, animations, comics, panel discussions, podcasts, which are really big, and much, much more.